Step-by-step filing of an online, fully developed claim for disability compensation. Today you expect to be able to do things online. You bank, pay bills, and shop online. Now VA allows veterans to file an electronic claim, or e-claim, for disability compensation online through the Joint VA-DOD eBenefits portal. Do you know that when you choose to work closely with a VSO and file an electronic disability compensation claim on eBenefits, you can file it as a fully developed claim, also known as an FDC? The FDC program is a voluntary program that allows you to submit all evidence and medical records at the same time you submit your claim. By doing this and certifying that you have no further evidence to submit, VA can process your claim quicker and make a faster decision. Why choose to do an electronic FDC? It helps you take charge of your claim by providing all the evidence at once. You can take advantage of a shortened web-based application process that reduces paperwork and allows for quicker claims processing than traditional claims. There's no risk to filing an FDC. If your claim does not qualify for FDC, it will still be processed traditionally. You have one full year to complete the application process, and if your claim is approved, you could be paid back to the day your claim was initiated. It decreases the amount of time VA spends developing your claim and contributes to reducing the claims backlog and claims processing timeframes. In this video, you will learn the step-by-step process for filing an electronic, fully developed claim for disability compensation on eBenefits. There are 9 basic steps to filing an FDC through eBenefits. Step 1. Log into eBenefits. To begin filing your electronic FDC for disability compensation, go to ebenefits.va.gov. Click the Login button in the top right-hand corner. If you do not have an eBenefits account, click Register and follow the step-by-step instructions to set up your account. You can also visit VBA's Media and Publications page to view our How to Get a DS Logon video. Once you are logged in, click Apply for Benefits. Step 2. Choose a VSO. VA strongly recommends that you go to the Request for Representative section to appoint an accredited Veterans Service Officer, or VSO, as your power of attorney before proceeding with your claims application. VSOs are no-cost advocates that will help you collect the required documents and evidence needed to submit your claim, as well as assist you with all of your other claims needs. Remember, merely selecting a VSO is not the same as working closely with one. You should be sure to contact the VSO you selected through eBenefits. Select Recognized Veterans Service Organization VSO. Then select the appropriate location by state and city or by zip code. Step 3. Enter personal information. Once you have requested a VSO representative, you can expect to hear back from them within a few days. If you do not hear back within 3 days, you should contact the VSO. The appointed VSO, once he or she agrees to serve as your representative, can then assist you in completing the application and gathering documents on your behalf. If you prefer to fill out the online application yourself, you should return to the Apply Now area to start a new electronic FDC application. Accept the terms and conditions, and then click Save and Continue on the Privacy Act statement. You will then be prompted to enter your VA file number. If you do not have a VA file number, select I do not have a VA file number. Your Social Security number will then serve as your file number. To fix incorrect personal information, click Edit Personal Information. Review the information at the Claim Notification page, then check I understand these terms and conditions, and click Save and Continue. It is important for you to know that once a claim has been initiated, but not submitted, you have 1 year to gather the required documents and information to complete your claim. Starting a claim before you have all your documents together allows the initiation date to serve as a placeholder. Read the informative material to understand the requirements and benefits of the FDC program, and then click Save and Continue. Step 4. Supply service information. Next, you will need to verify your service history and add a new period of service if one is missing. Verified service periods are marked verified and are not editable. Every question should be answered, and all applicable and required information should be inputted on the service information and military pay pages. Then click Save and Continue. Step 5. Choose your type of claim. On the Disability Records page, choose your type of claim. Choose an original disability claim if this is the very first claim you've ever filed for disability compensation. A new disability claim means a new claim for a service-connected disability that has not been filed before. If you choose to claim a new disability, enter your new disability information. Once you save and continue, the added disability will appear in the grid. A reopened disability claim indicates the reopening of a claim already filed that VA could not grant. To file this type of claim, the decision made by VA must be at least 1 year old, and you must have new and material evidence not previously considered in your claim. The evidence must be new and must also relate to the reason why VA previously denied the claim. An increased disability claim is a request for an increased evaluation of a disability that VA has already determined to be service-related because your condition has gotten worse. Finally, a secondary disability claim is a claim for a disability that developed as a result of, or was worsened by, a disability which VA has already determined to be service-related. Determine which claim you want to file, and then click Save and Continue. Each type of claim requires specific evidence that must be included when you submit your claim. Make sure you read and fully understand what documents must be included for your type of claim. Step 6. Enter treatment information. On the Confirm Treatment page, specify whether or not you have received medical treatment at a VA medical center. If yes, you'll go to the Medical Treatment Records page to provide all the information as directed. Make sure you click Save and Continue on each page. You will then go to the Direct Deposit page. It is important to remember, if you request VA assistance in gathering private medical evidence by completing VA Form 21-4142, Authorization and Consent to Release Information to the Department of Veterans Affairs, VA, your claim will not be processed as an FDC. As a result, it will take more time for VA to process your claim. To avoid this, you must upload copies of all private treatment records at the time the claim is submitted. You will learn how to upload records in a moment. As part of the process to gather medical evidence, you may also choose to submit appropriate disability benefits questionnaires, or DBQs. While not required, DBQs help speed up the FDC process by providing medical information that is directly relevant to determining your disability rating. DBQs are downloadable electronic forms that can be found on the eBenefits homepage or on the VA website. Once completed by a VA clinician or a private physician with an active medical license, DBQs serve as the equivalent of an examination at a VA facility. Submitting an appropriately completed DBQ along with an FDC may eliminate the need to attend a VA examination, putting you in a position to receive a VA benefits decision faster. If you are unable to obtain your federal records to support your FDC, then let VA know. Tell VA about any other records you may have with a federal agency, like workers' compensation, OWCP, or the Public Health Service. Step 7. Review special circumstances. Certain circumstances require a claimant to submit additional information. If any of these special circumstances applies to you and your claim, you must provide the additional documents when your claim is submitted. For example, if you are a National Guard or Reserve member, you must provide any and all service treatment and personnel records in the custody of your unit. Failure to provide this information may result in your claim being excluded from expedited FDC processing. Step 8. Upload documents. Next, you will need to gather all the relevant private medical treatment records required for your application and scan them into the computer. If possible, collect electronic versions of your medical records and required documents to avoid having to scan your information in. Keep in mind that only the following file types are acceptable to upload onto eBenefits: JPG, JPEG, GIF, TIFF, BMP, TXT, or PDF, unlocked. Make sure you save your document as one of these types before you upload them. Also note that the maximum acceptable file size is 5 megabytes. If you need to upload a file that's larger than 5 megabytes, split the file into separate files, then upload all files. If you have any trouble obtaining, scanning, or formatting your documents, make sure you contact your appointed VSO for assistance. Upload these documents with your application. These documents may include any DBQs you submit, treatment notes from private physicians, hospital records, outpatient records, and/or statements from your friends and family supporting your claim. First, select Add or Remove Files to begin uploading your documents. Select the drop-down menu to indicate the document type. Click Browse to navigate to the file or image you want to upload from the personal files stored on your computer. Highlight or click on the file or image, and then click Open. When the file name displays, click Upload. Upload as many files as you need to, and see them displayed in the grid. If an upload is unsuccessful, you'll see an error message. This page displays the documents you've successfully uploaded. Click Save and Continue. Make sure you review that all necessary documents have been uploaded to your application. Click Save and Continue. The Error Check page will display errors found during the application process. If errors exist, correct the errors and then click Recheck to make sure they've been fixed. Step 9. Perform final review and submit the application. The final validation page displays all the information you provided for your final review. If any information is incorrect or missing, you can navigate back to the appropriate page to correct it. For example, if a treatment record is missing, click on the Treatment Record tab. Update the information, then click Save and Continue. At this point, you are encouraged to have your appointed VSO review your claim to verify that it is complete before you submit it. The final step is to certify that you have enclosed all the information and evidence to support your claim. You may select No More Evidence or More Evidence from the drop-down menu. Your claim can only be processed as an FDC if you select No More Evidence. If you indicate that you have more evidence to submit after your application has been filed, your claim will no longer qualify for the FDC program. Click Continue. Then, certify that all the information is correct and true. Accept the terms and conditions, and click Submit. VA is now reviewing your claim. You will receive a confirmation number and notice at your eBenefits message center and via your email address on record, indicating that your claim was submitted successfully. Here are a few helpful tips and reminders to review before beginning the electronic FDC process. Work with a VSO throughout the claim filing process to ensure that your application is complete when it is submitted. Once you begin and save your FDC application on eBenefits and prior to submitting the claim, you have 1 year to gather all evidence and upload supporting documents to complete your claim. Make sure your claim package is complete before you submit the claim. If your claim is awarded, you may be retroactively paid back to the date you initiated your claim. Be sure to fill out information completely and submit all necessary evidence for your claim at the same time. If you submit additional information after your FDC has been submitted through eBenefits, your claim will be removed from the expedited FDC process and put in the standard claims process. If VA schedules a VA examination for you as part of your FDC claim, don't miss your appointment. If you miss it and subsequently request that VA reschedule it, your claim will be removed from the FDC process. As already mentioned, you also have the option to submit disability benefits questionnaires or DBQs along with your claim. DBQs, when filled out appropriately by a VA or private physician with an active medical license, provide medical information that is directly relevant to determining a disability rating. Including a DBQ with an FDC may eliminate the need for a VA medical examination, allowing the claim to be processed faster. A complete list of DBQ forms can be found at www.benefits.va.gov/compensation/dbq_disabilityexams.asp. If you cannot obtain your relevant federal records, then tell VA. You can check the status of your claim 24/7 by logging on to your eBenefits account and clicking View My Status in the top navigation bar. For more information on FDC claims, go to www.benefits.va.gov/FDC or reach out to your local VSO. Thank you for watching.